Hi, I'm Brent Tharp, Technical Product Manager at Wyffels. Today I'd like to shoot a quick video showing how you can determine stalk quality. As this corn crop starts to mature, it's a good time to get out in these fields and to determine stalk quality, because then you could start setting your harvest schedule. So this happens to be a good area of the field. You can see the good green color. Those ears have a brown husk on them. I pulled an ear here, just looking at the milk line development. You know, that kernel development, that milk line is all the way. It's not quite black layered. You can still feel a little bit of the soft milk at the very base, but it's not gonna be long that this crop is gonna be black layered. And if you can have a crop like this, it's green to the ground, we're gonna have good standability in that crop. We can do the pinch test. It's very solid. Do the push or the pull test here. You know, that it doesn't break over. The other thing you can do is take some pruning shears or a good sharp knife. You can cut the stalk and you can kind of look down and see that pith, how it's still, even it's got some juice around the rind and very solid all the way down to the base of the plant. And that is a good sign. If I had a whole field that looked like this, I wouldn't be too concerned about the stalk quality on it. So I moved down in the field here, and now I'm in the same hybrid, just in a different spot, a little lower area. This happened to be May 24th planted. And what I'm seeing in this particular area is that we're seeing some, probably some denitrification due to the, you know, the wet spring and this lower area of the field. And you can kind of see the color has gone out of this crop. Same hybrid, same planting date, just a few feet down from the good video. And if you can see down here, I pulled back some of the bottom leaves. You just don't have that green color. If you do a pinch test on this, it crushes pretty easy between your fingers. And a walk down here, you can kind of see even the sign of that black on there. That's anthracnose. So if you do a push test and those plants break over, or you can do a pull test, they shouldn't break over like this. So we're in an area that's not good. Now here's a better plant. It popped back up. There's another poor plant. So, you know, if the whole field was like this, I'd be wanting to get after this as soon as I possibly could, because we're a good windstorm away of the wind causing this these stalks to break over. I did the cut test on this plant, and if you compare it to the previous plant that was healthy that we did the cut test, you can kind of see this gap. You can kind of see the vascular, those pith and the bundles in there. And it's starting to separate from that rind. That, you know, you would pinch that and it's soft. That's an indication of poor stalk quality. So to wrap it up again, it's a good time to get out there and determine the stalk quality and start thinking about your harvest schedule. I guess fields that I'd be most concerned about first are fields that maybe where tar spot has moved in late. I don't think in a lot of these situations we've hurt yield, but it could determine or impact stalk quality, or any kind of disease that maybe moved in late during the grain fill period. And then fields that are showing, that have shown denitrification here at the end of the season, they're also probably not gonna have the best stalk quality. So I definitely target diseased fields, low nitrogen or denitrified fields, or even maybe your wetter fields, scout those first. Thanks for listening.